nightmare woke him up. Frightened by his mother's bedtime story, he searched for his sister's comfort. But she was nowhere to be found. There once was a girl who snuck out of her bedroom window at night, even though her mother had told her not to. She went into the forest, and at first it welcomed her with warmth and a promise of adventures. But soon, the forest seemed to grow colder, and the girl was afraid and she wanted to go home. But Bramble crawled around her arms and legs, and she could not get away. And the girl was never seen again. That is what happens when you do not listen to your mother. Especially you, Lilymoor, their mother had said before kissing them goodnight. The darkness outside scared him. But not being with his sister scared him even more. The nearby forest was a familiar place during the day. But at night, it was a different story. There was no trace of Lilymoor, and Ulle wished he could ask the pine cones if they had seen her. If the pine cones knew about her fate, they kept it to themselves. A light in the dark. A symbol of hope. A spark of courage. What do you have there? Lilimur asked. It glimmers beautifully. What a strange rock. Light as a feather. She investigated closely. Let us play, little brother, Lilimur bubbled. See if you can knock down this pine cone. Together, they tumbled down deeper and deeper through the old ruin. Follow me, little brother. I will protect you, Lila Moore said. She was never scared like him. Ulle wished he could be a little more like his sister. Lillemor loved adventures, and Ulle loved Lillemor. Gnomes are peculiar and playful creatures. They live peacefully in daylight and keep in their houses at night. Visitors that don't want to eat them were unheard of until this day.
You know.
They were both curious in different ways, while Lillemor quickly ran along. Ulle could get completely enthralled. And suddenly, Ulle was alone again.
Thank you.
The river was strong, and Ulle was weak. He did not stand a chance. But soon the sound of the river faded. Ulle was happy to have firm ground under his feet again. Frog King made sure that his new friend did not drown. But without his sister, he felt like the loneliest child in the world. He just wanted to find Lillimor and go home. To do that, he had to find where the big troll had taken her. Ah! Ulla wanted to cry. A couple of hours ago, he had been in his warm bed. Now, he had almost died several times. His sister was gone, and he was soaked in smelly sewer water.
Thank you.
Ull felt bad for the ill-treated giant. Lammas might be big, but he had a warm stone heart. All he longed for was a friend, but his face scared away most. Even so, it seemed like he had found one. Ulle was comforted by the morning sun. He had survived the night, but just barely. At least he had found the stone again. And it felt like it was his sister's way of telling him he was on the right path.
Det är rik Thank you.
In his past life, Nekin was a simple man that loved playing his violin. But the village did not appreciate his talent. People would frequently bully him, and the only soul that did not was a girl that Nekin fell in love with. One day, the bullying and beatings became so severe that Nekin's anger finally overtook him. He marched into the village, playing forbidden melodies that made everyone dance, until their flesh and bone got worn down. They eventually died, leaving behind shuffling corpses, still trying to dance to Nekin's melodies. His love was not spared death either. Devastated, Nekin left the town and lived by the lake, drowning in his sorrow, where he still lures people with his deadly music. closer and closer. He felt as if a darkness took hold of his heart and filled it with fear. Was a light. Tuva was a light in the darkness. She had filled his heart with courage, and the stone with her radiance. The bramble covers all where darkness has taken hold, Tuva said. Follow the light. You will find what you are searching for within the mountain. land was once a peaceful kingdom with a great king. Now, his image embodied the darkness that had drowned the world in Bramble. Laemus would always look after his only friend. Olle felt a chill as he saw the warnings for desperate mothers carrying their infants. They pleaded with them not to carry out the unspeakable acts they had set their minds to. Thank you.
wolves that circle round the sheep. A temporary sacrifice you make in order for your powers to awake. Trust in the transcendent and surrender to be received into the arms of splendor. Behold the transmutation into gold.
Witch was ahead of him. Olle knew he had to hurry before she could complete the ritual. If he did not catch up with the woman, the swamp would swallow another child. But he did not know that someone else wanted to hold him back. A midwife who wanted more dark souls to take care of. Ulla had been too late. At least he could give the child a proper burial, so that it would not become another dark soul. There was a light in the darkness. Guilt and sorrow weighed him down, but the warm glow felt comforting. Follow the light, Tuva had said, and he trusted her. Lichtgube was older than the mountain, almost as old as the world itself. He was the keeper of secrets, the gatherer of stories. Long ago, there was a peaceful kingdom that lacked an heir to the throne. King Nils and his queen Magdalena had waited for a long time, and at last she was expecting a child. She gave birth to the longed-for son, and they named him Ulrik. But suddenly, doctors crowded around the queen's bed. Magdalena succumbed to the labors of childbirth. The love of his life was gone. Weighed down by sorrow, King Nils approached his autumn. Meanwhile, Ulrik grew into a young boy full of life. The prince was the only thing that kept the darkness at bay in his heart. One day, Prince Ulrik fell ill. The doctors tried everything, but he grew weaker and weaker. They told King Nils about a mythical flower that witches were rumored to use to heal any illness. King Nils searched the whole kingdom for the flower to no avail, and his campaign soon became a gruesome witch hunt. His path was lined with the witches he had slain, but the flower was nowhere to be found. Ulle wished he could stay in the warm light of the library. But he knew that he needed to reach the mountain and find Lillemor. Suddenly, he heard a familiar voice. "Follow me, little brother. I will protect you." Thank you.
Thank you.
Ulla, what have you done? Tuva's voice called out to him. Once there was a peaceful village near a great forest. One night, people began to see a beautiful woman with long dark hair lurking in the shadows during the full moon. Men started to follow her into the forest. Some of them never returned, and those who did had lost their minds. Eventually, the villagers had enough. They took all the dark-haired women of a certain age and put them on trial for witchcraft. They started to execute them, hoping to find the right one. Yet men kept disappearing during full moon nights. The villagers grew more and more desperate and burned down a large area of the forest in the hope of finding this strange, beautiful woman, but to no avail. The villagers had lost themselves. They killed their own mothers and daughters. They burned down more of the forest that had served them with resources. Then one night, when the moon shone at its brightest, five brave men took matters into their own hands. They put on their coats and walked into the burnt forest to hunt for the woman with the dark hair. After a time, they saw the beautiful woman standing in a clearing. The men were instantly enchanted and followed her deep into the forest's heart. She was a shapeshifter that mimicked what men wanted to see in order to lure them away. When they were close enough to touch her, she transformed into something monstrous. She ripped their chests open, hung them up in the trees, and drew strange powers from their still beating hearts. And no one would ever see them again. Dear diary, I am so in love with him. I cannot even describe it. It feels like he loves me too. Our village still tries to heal its wounds from the dark days, but at least me and my love survived and have each other. After the horrible witch hunt, we thought we were safe. We thought we would have peace, but then the plague came to our village. It feels like the plague is some kind of punishment for our sins. Maybe we deserve this. People say they have seen an old woman with a rake at night. Every house she passes, people inside get sick. I hope she does not come to my house. Every morning, someone new has fallen ill, and shortly thereafter, they die. We do not even dare to give them a proper funeral. It is horrible. The dead are rising from their graves, and they eat the ones left alive. I have locked myself in the house. I got separated from my love. I wish I could be with him. I hope I can meet him in the next life. I'm out of food, and the dead are right outside my door. I miss him so much.
Huh.
come back.
Overcome the darkness. He had reached the mountain. He could finally find his sister. As he reached the summit, Ole felt regret. Regret that he could not stop his sister from being taken. Regret that he could not stop the woman from drowning her child. Shapeshifter in the forest. Now the mountain stood before him, and he wished he could ask their forgiveness. He had reached the end that Tuva had pointed him towards. Now, entering the halls of the mountain, Ulle was ready to find his sister. Thank you. Exhausted, bloody, and at his wit's end, King Nils came to a witch's house on the outskirts of his kingdom. He fell to his knees, begging the witch to help cure his son, and she agreed. The witch explained that the flower held tremendous power that could only very carefully be used for good. The witch instructed he only use a single petal. Using the whole bloom would only invite death. Ulrich began to recover, but discontent at the royal line had grown in the kingdom following King Nils' bloody campaign. The next day, King Nils found his son dead, and the last light holding his darkness at bay was snuffed out. Heartbroken, King Nils turned to the bloom which had promised life, and instead saw it as an escape from his suffering. The witch, having come to visit the king and the prince, looked at the nightmarish scene in despair. She raised a mountain on top of King Nils and shackled him using the same bramble that he let loose upon the kingdom. And to this day, the trolls still feed him as punishment for his evil deed. Thank you. Mountain King, who was meant to be hidden forever, was now revealed. He just had to reach the sack before Lilimur ended up as the giant's dinner.
Thank you.
bramble weakened. The Mountain King saw clearly for the first time in centuries. And what he saw reminded him of his beloved son. He would not lose him again. This time, King Nils would overcome the darkness. Blossomed. King Nils tore the bramble rooted in his back and brought it all to an end. The only way to get to Lilimur was now up and in. Tuva had one last gift to give to Ole. A nightmare woke her up. frightened by her memories. She searched for her brother's comfort. But he was nowhere to be found. However, the darkness outside did not scare her. Because she knew she had her brother.